Good day, very good evening to all my friends, fellow travelers, photographers around the world. Welcome to Chris Lee Travel Channels. I wish you all in good health. Further to my last week episodes, in today's episode, this is also the 8th episode of my travel journey to Guizhou province of China. I'm sharing with you 4 more interesting places, namely the Qiao Jie, right, or Qiao Straits in Liping, as can be seen in this image, and also 2 more Dong villages, the Tang'an Dong village, as well as the Dimen Dong village. And all these 3 spots are located within the Liping County. And while the last spot or last interest place of today's visit is to a public square in the Congjiang City in Congjiang County, which have one of the tallest drum towers in China. That is the Congjiang Drum Towers. So please stay tuned until the end of this episode as to view all these 4 interesting places. Now, for viewers that first time log into this series of my travelogues, the Guizhou, China, please note that the area color in red in this map of China is the whereabout of Guizhou province, a landlocked and mountainous province. Now, we are still covering the Qingdongnan, Miao and Dong prefectures in these episodes, which is been highlighted in yellow color in this map. Now, the first 3 spots that I'm going to share with you today is located in Liping County, as highlighted in these provincial maps of Guizhou. So it's important to note that my Guizhou journey took place in the year 2011. Thus, all images in these travelogues are of 10 years old. Viewers are reminded that the present conditions of these villages and the living standard of the villagers could be different from my travelogue images. Now, if you are the first time log into my travel channel and you want to have a better understanding of Guizhou province and the unique minority cultures, the custom and tradition, please view the previous episodes of my journey to this Guizhou province. Let's begin our remaining journey in this prefecture by starting off with this popular street in Liping City. Now, Qiao Jie or Qiao Street is an old street in Liping City in Liping County of the South-eastern Guizhou. It's a must-visit site, not only for its historical value, but also for its ancient building architectures. It is famous for being the site for the holding of Liping Conference in December 1934. Now, the first meeting of a political bureau of the Communist Party of China during the Long March, which formed October, 16th October 1934 till 19 October of 1935 for 369 days. So a museum was built to commemorate this important conference, as can be seen in this image. The location of this museum is right at the middle sections of the street. Opposite the museum, across the street, is the venue of the meeting. And you can see the arrow, the red arrow pointed region in this image is the location where this conference was held. Today, this street is a site for the experience of the legacy of Red Army revolutions, and the site is being listed as the National Protected Historical and Cultural Site by the China government in the year 2006. It's a 600 years old street built during the Ming Dynasty, that's during the 1368 to 1644, and now live with about 380,000 Dong residents, also known to be the largest Dong community in China. Now, another attraction of this street is the Hui ancient building architectural style. As most buildings built in this street, right, were dated back to Ming and Qing dynasty. So the unique roof facade dominates the entire street from end to end, as can be seen in these images. Another key feature of this Hui architecture is the beautiful stone cladding, the stone facade, right, on the wall. So this image here you now can see clearly of the stone facade of this building. We come across a primary school and as well as a church within the vicinity of this street, and also a old office of labor union in China. This old fire hydrant pillar was spotted at one corner of the street. I believe its age definitely were more than 50 years or more. And here an aged cantilever roof in one of the building entrance. Now the building along the street as well as the surrounding area are rich in decorative and intricate woodworks well displayed in these and foreign images. I would like you to pay attention to the curved wooden panel claddings right below the balcony or even the window on the first floor and right above the window at the ground floor, the center portion. And this is a very, very unique piece of architecture style that you can find in this street. More images for you to see. At the same time, another unique feature is that these old streets, most of the area are stone paved. Now in this image, what you are seeing is an old, considered one of the oldest traditional Chinese medicine shops, with at least a century old. And the interior of this shop is look like this, and the herbs are kept in the drawers on the wall cabinets. Now most shops on these streets sell handmade unique Dong products, such as traditional dresses, art, handicraft, ornamentals, silverware, wooden products. And in this image, these wooden buckets are used for food baiting. There are quite a number of eateries selling local snack and catering meal for the locals as well as for visitors. Myself and my wife have a nice meal at this shop, and I have ordered a plate of fried rice while my wife ordered a plate of fried noodle. In general, the people in this community are very friendly to visitors. So from now, I'm going to share with you more straight portraiture of the local. Indeed, this is a straight for the learning of Li Ping Yinik culture and the Yinik Dong culture. So now we have come to our next stop in our today's journey, that is the Tang'an Dong village. Now, Tang'an Dong village is a very scenic and smaller Dong village located about 6 km northeast of South-eastern Dong village in Liping County. Now this village is located in a very beautiful countryside with all round greenery on the mid hill of a Mount Longbao. It's about 840 meters above sea level, a relatively undisturbed Dong village in these regions. The smaller green dots on this map are the smaller villages in this region, and Tang'an is just one of them. So let's look at this tourist map of Tang'an. Our starting point of this tour were from the village entrance gate or arch, as highlighted in the map. This is the image of the entrance arch of this village. A very typical Dong architecture style, roofed arch gate. Now this image and the subsequent images were taken while walking from the gate toward the center regions of the village. And you can see that the village been surrounded by charming hill, but also enclosed by a large area of terraced paddy field located at the lower portion of the village, and as well as the bottom of the valley regions. As our arrival was in the morning, so we spotted villagers at work in their farmland. It's important to note that the time of our visit is mid-April. It's actually during the spring season, and which actually also the farming season for them. As this region is very hilly and mountainous, so flatland are very, very rare or limited. So most farmland are being terraced. Therefore, farming can only be done manually, as can be seen in this image and subsequent images of the villagers doing the farming manually. So while we are walking toward the center region of the village, so strolling along the streets of this traditional village bring you close encounter to the villagers. And a typical feature of Dong village is a wind and rain bridge, which built in every village, right? Is this wind and Dong, the rain and wind and rain bridge was built at the bottom of the village, and it actually turned the whole area into a picturesque scenes, which can't be resisted by most landscape photographers, which including me. And you notice that actually, as like in my earlier episodes, both in Dong and Miao villages, the roof when the building are constructed mainly of wooden structures. And for the most recent completed buildings, their roof of course is covered with roof tile. And you can spot it most of the times, the walkway, the path, village path or alley are mostly stone paved, as can be seen in these few images. The villagers place their graveyard, the grave of their beloved family members, next to their home. If we do spot any building that with roof constructed and covered with tree barks, this implies that these buildings are fairly old. During our visit, we met with many of the locals. They are very, very friendly, hospitable, and this added many sweet memories to my journey. And most of the villagers that we met were either of elderly age or young kids. And most of the young kids, of course, are being taken care of by the grandmothers. And while on the way out from the village, I spotted this wooden cart. Looked very unique. And I also spotted a signboard. In this village, it seems like this village also provides trekking trail guide to its visitor. So now we move on to our third stop in today's episode. It's also the last stop in Liping County. That is the Dimen Dong village. Now, this is another traditional and undisturbed Dong village located about 4 km north of Maikong town, right? And it's about 45 km away from Liping town, right? In the Liping County. It's been regarded as the second largest Dong village in China, which about 500 plus households and near to 2,300 inhabitants. Now the village sited on a very beautiful valley next to a river with fine numbers of well-preserved wind and rain bridges spanning across the river. And for this reason, the given name of this village, Dimen, in Dong language, carry the meaning of the originated ground or places. And we started our journey to this village while the entrance gates, a roofed arch gate as usual in Dong architecture style. So this is actually the entrance arch gate of this village. In this tourist map of the Dimen Dong village, could you spot the river that flow through the village and their wind and rain bridge of a total of 5 number as well as the drum tower? All this could only be found in Dong village. Now, Dimen Dong village also been divided into 5 groups, namely the Wei, the Mo, the Meng, the Mu, and also the Yin, each with his own drum towers. Among these 5 towers, the drum tower of the Mu group is being regarded as the root of the originated 1,300 household of this village. Of course, now have reduced to 500 households. The others 800 households have moved out from this village. There are many well-protected cultural reliefs in this village, particularly there are wooden bridges and drum tower within the village, which have enhanced and bring out the strong and unique innate Dong cultures and traditions. Now, another important item to look out for while touring the Dong villages is the painting on the wall of the drum towers and also in the wind and rain bridges. If you have followed my earlier episodes, you will understand how important and valuable of this painting to the Dong people. Now, this village is relatively undisturbed by tourists and is one of the many untouched and very peaceful Dong villages in these regions. Indeed, it is a tranquil village with charming landscapes. The villagers we met all were very friendly with us. The villagers' kids were very, very cute and charming. And I'm much pleased that I could immerse myself in this traditional yet beautiful Dong village with incredible countryside views. And a big thanks to my travel agent, Yonggo Travel, for such a beautiful itinerary being set out for this journey. And now we move out from the Liping County and arrive at the Congjiang County to witness one of the highest wooden drum towers in Guizhou. Some people like to refer it as a Congjiang Drum Tower. And the location in Congjiang County is as highlighted in these provincial maps of Guizhou and is almost border, right, a border to Guangxi province and also Hunan province. So here is a wooden drum tower built on a public square in Congjiang City of Congjiang County, and of course in the Qingdongnan, Miao and Dong prefectures. Now the drum tower was constructed completely used of wood. Sited in the drum tower square, a public square, next to the Liujiang, a river, or Liu River, and it is given a name, the Congjiang Gulou, or Congjiang Drum Tower. Now this wooden drum tower is been regarded as the tallest drum tower in southern Guizhou, fully using local species of wood. It is a 27-floor wooden structure adopting a multi-column design supported by 32 wooden pillars. Among these 32 pillars, four of them are of size large enough for two adults to embrace them. So now you can see the interior of this wooden drum tower and the key support, the four main pillar, round pillar. Again, the assembly and the connection of all these timber members are without the use of any metal nails or screw. And next to the public square stood two long pieces of mural wall that release exhibit the culture, custom and tradition of the ethnic minority of these regions. Now along the river, the Lujiang River, one could spot a row of 50 plus gigantic size of maple trees. And some of these maple trees are of age more than 400 years old. It is another picture squad site for photographer. And among these 50 plus old maple trees, I was told four of them are so huge in size that two adults holding hand to hand also cannot embrace them, right? Embrace the tree trunk. You can see that my wife can even hide into the tree trunk. The river also has the legends of a loving couple. Many like to refer it as an oriental Romeo and Juliet. And not far from the riverbank, located a famous traditional Dong village known as the San Bao Zhen Old Dong Village. It's also worth a visit if we have the extra time. And finally, here come the end of my 8th episode of my journey to Guizhou, and hope you have been entertained. Now, if you like my travel channels, please support by subscribing, sharing, and like. A thumb up from you is very important to me. I would like to take this opportunity to thank you in advance for supporting this travel channel. And just a preview, in the coming 9 episode, I will bring you to a southwestern end of regions of Guizhou. That means we are moving out from these prefectures. Our focus in the next 3 episodes will be mainly on the unique crust, landform, and natural scenery in the southwestern region of Guizhou. We also cover the ancient town, and we still retain most of the traditional of the Ming dynasty culture and clothing and lifestyle, as well as a hilltop temples. So before I would end, I would like to wish you all good health. So please stay safe and stay strong. And I shall see you next week. Bye.